Welcome to this new Inside Code video where we will see the good parse problem. So what does the problem say? It says, given an array of integers r, create a function that returns the number of good pairs, where pair ig is called good if I is smaller than g and r of I is equal to r of g. In other words, if we find an element that has a certain value, then we find that value again in a further index, then we found a good pair. I is smaller than g means that the index of the first element of the pair comes before the second one in r. Now pause the video and try to solve this problem in O of n time complexity. I hope that you try to solve the problem, so let's start. Evidently this problem is quite easy, but I chose it so that I can show you how can we optimize a solution by using a hash map, as we will do for this problem. Because the first solution that may come in your mind is the brute force solution, where we just check all possible pairs while counting the ones that respect the condition. So for each element, we traverse the remaining ones, and if we find an element r of g that is equal to r of I, it means that we found a good pair, so we just increment the counter. With this array, for example, this is what would happen. The code for this solution is also easy to understand because we just put a counter that starts at 0, we use a for loop to traverse elements of r, inside it we use another for loop to traverse elements after the index I, this is why g starts at I plus 1. Now we just have to check if r of I is equal to r of g, and if it's the case, as said earlier, it means that we found a good pair, so we increment count. After the outer loop, we just return count. And by the way, here we didn't check if I is smaller than g, which is a necessary condition, because g always starts at I plus 1, so we'll never have a case where I is not smaller than g. This solution works and is easy to understand, but the problem is its time complexity, which is O of n squared because of the nested loops. We are always retraversing r, and it's not the most efficient solution because we want a solution in linear time, O of n, so we have to find a way to traverse the array only once, which is not the case here. To solve this problem in linear time, we will need a hash map, and let me show you how we're gonna use it here. But before, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel, it will motivate me to produce more videos and more content. Now that you like the video, I hope it's the case, let's see how will the hash map help us with this problem. For this method, we will use the fact that if an element r of I has the value k, and we've already seen that value n times before in the array, then r of I is the second element of n good pairs. In other words, we found n new good pairs. Let me give you some examples. For example, here at index 5, we have the value 2, and you can see that we already found the value 2 twice before arriving at index 5. It means that r of 5 is the second element of two good pairs, this one and this one. Then at index 8, you can see that we already found the value 2 thrice, so it's the second element of three good pairs, this one, and this one. Another example, at index 6, we have the value 5 that we already saw once before, so we found a new good pair. This is why we would add 1 to the counter, and you will see it later. So, in general, at each index, if we already saw that value n times before, then we add n to the counter. That's the main strategy of this second solution. Okay, but now you may tell me, to know how many times we've seen the actual value, we'd have to retraverse the array until the actual index, and we'd end up with an O of n squared time complexity. Where is the optimization then? The optimization comes from the fact that instead of always retraversing the array, we will use a hash map to keep track of how many times we visited each value. If you don't know what is a hash map, know that it's a data structure where each element consists of a key and a value. And in our case, the key is a number present in the array, and the value is the number of times we've seen it before. Now here is our hash map that is actually empty, here is our counter that is initialized to 0, and let's get the number of good pairs by traversing the array only once. The first element is 2, and you can see that we didn't see a 2 before, because we don't have it in our hash map, so we just mentioned that we found the value 2 once, and we continue. Second element is 5, same thing, we didn't see it before, we put it in the hash map, and we continue. Third element, 1, same thing, and we continue. Now we have the value 2, and from the hash map, we can know that we've seen it once before, so we add 1 to our good pairs counter, and we increment the number of times we've seen the number 2, because now we've seen it twice. We continue, we have the value 3, which we didn't see before, we just put it in the hash map and we initialize to 1. We continue, we have the value 2 again, and from the hash map we know that we've seen it twice before, so we add 2 to our counter and we increment in the hash map. We continue, we have the value 5 now, and we already saw it once, so we add 1 to the counter, and we increment in the hash map. Next element, 1, we've seen it before once, so same thing, we add 1 and we increment. Next element, the value 2 again, and here we've seen it thrice, so we add 3 and we increment in the hash map. Last element, 1, we've seen the value 1 twice before, so we add 2 to the counter and we increment. We finished traversing R and you can see that we found 10 good pairs. You can see them at the bottom of the screen. Before moving to the code, let me give you the two reasons why I chose to use a hash map. The first one is because we don't need to know what values are gonna be in the structure before starting. Here we didn't know that we will find a 2, a 5, a 1, etc. We just created an empty hash map and we created a new key value every time we found a new key that we didn't have before. Yes, we could also do it with an array, but the difference is that if we want to know how many times we visited the value 1 for example, we may need to traverse the whole array, but with a hash map, accessing and inserting elements is done in O of 1 in average, which is a huge advantage that will reduce our time complexity to O of n. Let's move to the code to better understand. We have the function that takes R as parameter, and inside we create our hash map that will contain how many times we visited each value, and we also create and initialize our counter to 0. Now we can start traversing the elements of R. For each element in R, we have two cases. Either we visited the actual value or we didn't. If we visited the actual value, then we add the number of times we did it before, and we increment that number in the hash map, because it's important to not forget the actual element. Else if it's the first time we meet that value, then we just create the key in the hash map and we set it to 1, because it's the first time. After the loop, the counter now holds the number of good pairs, we return it. Now for the time complexity, here we have a loop that is traversing R, so it will be repeated n times, where n is the number of elements of R. And inside we are accessing and inserting elements in the hash map, but as said earlier, those operations are O of 1 in average. So multiplied by the number of iterations of the loop, we get an O of n time complexity, which is better than the first solution. And for the space complexity, we use extra space for storing the elements of the hash map, and we can have n elements in the worst case, when every value is unique in R, so the space complexity is O of n. I hope that you understood both solutions. If you had to remember only one thing from this video, it's that if you're stuck on optimizing your brute force solution, then try to use a hash map and see if it helps. Constant time access and insertion is really powerful. We arrived at the end of this video, don't forget to check the description to find the code of both solutions, please give me your feedback in comments, and you can also ask me questions if you didn't understand something, and see you in the next video.